Hey there everyone and welcome. Today I'm going to be showing you a very cool little technique to create vector patterns, organic vector patterns inside of words in Illustrator. Now they don't necessarily have to be words, they can be shapes as well, but we're going to be concentrating on this word right now, and you will need Photoshop as well. So if you got it, fire it up. You can't do this technique without Photoshop. I'm currently using CS5. I have not made the jump yet to CS6 CC, but that's another story. All right, so let's get started. I'm going to go back to the original here and go back to the original. I'm sure all of you guys know how to get this far. Okay, this is just a word with a font called El Grande, and it's got a slight arc on it. But get this far and we can begin. Okay. So the first thing you need to do is actually option drag a copy of your word or shape, and now you've got a copy, and we need to offset this path so it fits into the original word that we have. So we're going to offset this path in the appearance panel, and if you're not familiar with the appearance panel, I highly suggest you look into it. It's a fantastic, useful tool. And I use it pretty much on every project I do in Illustrator, so look into it. And if you don't have your appearance panel here in your side panel here, just go up to Window and slide down to Appearance, click on Appearance, and it should be available to you then. All right, so we're going to offset this path, and how you do that, make sure that your copy is selected. All right, in the appearance panel, click on the effects icon, slide down to Path, and offset the path. Okay, and I think my path was a -3 with a round join. We're going to preview that. As you can see, the whole thing shrunk. And I think I'm actually going to go with a -4. Yeah, let's go with a -4. Hit OK. And with your copy still selected, your offset path copy still selected, go up to Object and expand its appearance. Now that created outlines around your word. It is now considered a shape, okay, or a series of shapes. And we're going to take this word and we're going to actually bring this into Photoshop. You know what I'd like to do actually also first, before we do that, is with your selected shapes, go into the appearance panel again, and we're going to go into the add new fill icon next to the effects. Click on add new fill, and what that does is basically it controls the color now from the appearance panel. But let's just, for the sake of argument here, let's make it yellow. Sure, we'll make it yellow. And just drag it up there and see how it fits inside your original word. That looks pretty good. All right, so we're going to take this yellow zebra here. And we're going to take this and we're going to bring it into Photoshop. So how we do that, we Command C it. All right, you can also go up to Edit and copy it from there if you wish. And so we've got this yellow zebra inside our clipboard, and we're going to go into Photoshop now and open a new document. All right, so we've got our new document. The preset is clipboard. I think it just assumes that what you have in the clipboard is the default, but make sure that your preset is clipboard. Say OK and paste it with a Command V into Photoshop and paste it as a path. Okay, so you've got your Photoshop document open with the word zebra inside it, and what I'd like to do is actually I would like to make this canvas a little bigger. So I'm gonna go with a quick and dirty way is to take your crop tool, crop the whole thing, and then just open up the crop past your borders of your artwork, of your layout here. Hit OK. I know that CS6 does it a different way, but anyway, CS5 does it this way. Don't worry about what your background color is, because we're going to add a gradient to this that will take care of that for us. So go into your gradient tool, the next step. Go into your gradient tool, click on your gradient tool with a black and white gradient, and just drag a nice gradient vertically on your artboard here. That's not too bad. You can experiment with this. The whole point of this stuff is to experiment. But I think that's a pretty good drag right there, what I got. It's not too much gray, not too much white. It's kind of somewhere in between, all right? So we've got this word with a gradient on it, and we need to actually take this up to a grayscale, all right? Right now it's in RGB mode, but we need to take it to grayscale. So click on grayscale inside your image menu, and this new window, just discard it. Don't worry about it. All right. But we're not quite there yet. We need to take this to a different mode again and go up to Image, Mode, and Bitmap. Okay. Now, bitmap is kind of a cool thing. This is where the fun stuff starts. All right. The method we're going to be using is halftone screen, but I highly encourage you to look into other things as well. Play around with it. We're going to use halftone screen for now. And it's going to be a, yeah, it's 180 pixels was our input, and 180 it will be our output. So then click OK. And the frequency is just, this is the amount of lines inside our halftone screen. The higher this number, the more lines you're going to get. I'm going to stick with 18 and click OK. And as you can see, it created a halftone pattern with lines on our artboard. The next step is where we take it into the Liquify filter. But the Liquify filter is not available to us because we are in a bitmap mode right now. All right, so we need to get this back into grayscale. Go back to Image and Grayscale. All right, size ratio is 1, perfect. And that will allow us to liquify it. So go up to Filter and Liquify. All right, and if you're not too familiar with the Liquify filter, just, you know, poke around in here, have some fun. I'm not going to get into it too much. I'm going to be using some of these tools over here, like the forward warp tool, the twirl tool, and the turbulence tool. I'm going to start with the turbulence tool. I got a nice size brush over here, about 226, and I'm just going to kind of mess around here and warp these lines. You don't want to go too far. You can see it kind of lifts up the tent here, you know, peeking under the tent. You want to see if you can avoid that. And it does it for, as well for the top. So see if you can avoid that if you can. So stay away from the edges, and just kind of, you know, move your lines around. This is a good time to take the twirl tool also. If you're using the twirl tool, if you hit Option, it will twirl it in the opposite direction. All right, so mix it up, have some fun. I don't want to get too much into this right now because I want to keep this tutorial short. I'm not doing artwork here. I'm just showing you how to do it, okay? The real work is up to you. All right, so I'm still not happy with that, I know. It's all right. So let's go with this. Looks good. Looks good so far. Yeah, sure. All right, so that's where we're going to start this. We're going to leave this as is right here, and we're going to hit OK. All right, you can see your original word zebra still kind of behind it. And you've got your squiggly lines, your liquefied lines, and in Photoshop, click on your select tool, and we're just going to drag this in to Illustrator below it. All right. So we don't need Photoshop anymore. You can get rid of it. We've got our Photoshop lines in here in Illustrator. And what we're going to do is we're going to live trace this, and we're going to actually live trace it, but we need to click on the tracing options to live trace it, because we want to see what's going on here. The very first thing you want to do is click on the ignore white, all right? Because we don't care about the white, we just care about the black lines at this point. Then click on preview, and it's going to give you a little tracing preview, and you can see it's still real jagged, it's kind of funky. So let's go to threshold, and we're going to drop this threshold a little bit, and it should smooth out some of those lines. We might even drop it a little more. That's pretty good. And let's add a blur to it. We're going to add a 0.5 blur to it. And you can see that cleaned it up really quite nice. Might even try a little more, 0.75. Yeah, it's actually cleaning it up good. How about just 1 pixel blur? Yeah, look at that. That's looking pretty good. All right, so we've got our kind of, you can mess around with it a little bit, but it's smoothed it out pretty nice. We got the preview fills. Make sure your ignore white is selected and trace it. All right, it's traced. Now we're just going to expand it. Now we've got black lines on no background. It's just black lines right now. So what I'd like to do is take these, or shapes, I should say, black shapes. I'm going to take these black shapes and I'm going to turn them into, like a white, okay? Be aware that if you want to make these a color, let's just, for sake of argument, make this a color. It's red, all right? You can see that it actually didn't turn it red. It turned it gray, all right? The reason for that is because it was dropped into Illustrator as a grayscale object. So if you go up to your color palette here, make it RGB, make sure it's selected, make it RGB, and you can see that it turned the color of your choice, and you can make this any color you want now. You got to keep it selected though, folks, okay? Keep it selected, any color you want, but I'm going to stick with a white, okay? So let's stick with white. And okay, so we've got our white pattern down here. We've got our zebra, yellow zebra, our original yellow zebra, that we're going to use as a clipping mask, okay? And in order to use a clipping mask, this mask needs to be in front of your object that you're masking. So we're going to right click the arrange and bring to front, okay? Now, the next step, there's a few things here that get a little funky. I'm going to actually hope that it gets funky. That way, when you're following along, you can work it out also. And you'll see from my mistakes and be able to fix it on your own. So we've got our pattern below. We've got our yellow zebra that we're going to be using as our clipping mask. It is in front of our pattern. All right. Drag it down below and select both of them. Now you can see, you know what, just for the sake of so we can see it better, we're going to select our pattern, all right? And we're going to make it another color just so we can see it better, okay? You can see that our lines, in comparison to the word that we're using, actually, why don't we just drag this down, all right? Drag it down, and we kind of have a dead spot up here. So we'll grab this, open it up even more, all right? Your whole word is covered with your pattern, and your pattern is below the clipping mask. So select both of them, and you can see when you right click it, I'm looking for an option here to make it a clipping mask, and I can't do it, okay? So what I need to do, and the reason that is because our zebra word is not a compound path, okay? A compound path meaning Illustrator is not considering this one object, all right? So we need to go up to object and make it a compound path. And now that really kind of screwed things up. I don't know what happens here. I have no idea. But the reason that happened is because I need to do one other step. So I'm going to Control Z that and back it up. All right. So what I did was I basically undid that move. All right. So select your non-compound path word that you're using as your clipping mask, and then go into your Pathfinder, and then just in shape mode, just unite the whole thing. It's going to turn it a different color, doesn't matter, okay? And then go up, make sure your word is still selected, then go up to compound path and make it a compound path, okay? I'm going to actually stick this back to white. All right, so we've got our white pattern, we've got our word here, select them both, and our word is a little, it's not in the right place. We're going to bring this down even more. You can comparison to our pattern. All right, so we've got our pattern, we've got our word on top, and we can select them both now, make clipping mask, and it's made a clipping mask. You can't see it yet, but if you drag it up to our original word, then there you have it, okay? You can change the colors, you can change pretty much, well, you can go in here and use the smooth tool if you're not happy with it, but you can take this and make it as large as you want. Without losing any clarity. It's a cool little organic pattern that you created both in Photoshop and Illustrator. And that's pretty much it. You can add all the flourishes you want to everything, but it's a good starting point. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and that should do it. Let me know how you like it. Play around with these filters back here in the bitmap part. It's a lot of fun. You can draw things on there with you know, your you can do all that kind of stuff. Have some fun. Let me know how it works out for you. And I appreciate your time, folks. All right? Enjoy your day.
Hey, hoppas ni lär er något.